Hello students, welcome to Saurav sir's classes. In our today's video, we are going to talk about different policy measures taken by government and its impact on the IS curve in the ISLM model. So today we are going to talk the fiscal policy changes and the shift of the IS curve. So let me first tell you that what is fiscal policy. Government undertakes two types of policies. One is the fiscal policy and the second is the monetary policy. Now, what is the difference between fiscal policy and monetary policy? Now, in case of fiscal policy, the policy instruments which the government has are change in taxes, change in government expenditure, and in case of monetary policy, the policy instrument which the government has is the control of money supply control on government bonds repo rate and interest. So government can undertake any of these two policies according to the demand of the situation. In our today's video, we are going to talk about fiscal policy only. Now, let me tell you what is an ISLM model. ISLM model is a Keynesian framework model and it is derived from the SKM theory. SKM is simple Keynesian model. ISLM curve or simply the IS model can help policy makers predict what will happen to aggregate output and interest rates if they decide to increase the money supply or government spending, that is the expenditure part which I told you here. So ISLM analyze the answer of some questions about the usefulness and efficiency of the monetary and the fiscal policy undertaken by the government. So basically, ISLM model helps us to determine, or rather helps the government to determine that what should be the aggregate output and what should be the equilibrium interest rate in the economy, so that there should be an equilibrium prevailing. The equilibrium prevailing in the market. Okay, so IS means the investment. IS means the investment and savings curve. So this curve discuss about the investment part and the savings part. So the first fiscal policy change which we are going to analyze now is the effect of an increase in the government expenditure. So now we are going to analyze the change in government expenditure, that is increase in G. Now when does the government expenditure rises? The government expenditure rises when the government fails to intervene in the market so that they can create some purchasing power, they can create some employment in the economy, or the government can increase its expenditure for many reasons. Suppose there is unemployment prevailing in the economy, so for creating employment government can invest in the market so that they may create some employment by digging holes. As a result, the purchasing power will increase of the common people. So there are many reasons that why government should increase their money supply. Now we are going to analyze that what is the effect on IS curve when government increases the money supply. When government increases the expenditure. So let us draw a graph where on the x-axis we are measuring the income or the output, and the y-axis we are measuring the interest rate. Suppose initially the IS curve is IS1 and the LM curve is LM1. Now government increases its expenditure, that is G increases, so IS curve will shift from IS1 to IS2. So there is a shift towards the right in IS curve from IS1 to IS2. Now we will analyze that what is its impact on output and on the interest rate. So initially the equilibrium was at this point, output was at Y1 and interest rate was R1, but after the government increase in government expenditure, the equilibrium point shifted to this point from A to B, and the output increased from Y1 to Y2 and the interest rate rises from R1 to R2. So now the question is, why LM curve did not shift? Why there is no effect on LM curve? So LM curve is only affected when there is any change in money market. So we will do money market later in the video. First we will analyzing the goods and services market. So now this thing is very important, that whenever there is a change in goods and service market, then only IS curve shifts. It may shift to the right or it may shift to the left, but it changes only when there is a change in goods and service market. And LM curve changes when there is a shift in, or when there is a change in money market equilibrium. Okay. Now the question here is that why this interest rate is rising. So let me tell you that since the money supply is not changing, so the money supply is remaining constant or it is fixed, so the total money demand cannot increase. The attempt to hold more money will raise the interest rate to reduce the speculative demand for money. demand for money. Okay, so at new equilibrium, that is at B, the rate of interest must rise sufficiently so that the net money demand remain unchanged even at a higher level of income. Now the important thing to analyze here is that what is the total change in the output level. Okay, so at R1 level and with the new IS, the output would have been say Y3. So this amount of change, is can be represented by the change in government expenditure times the multiplier, this thing. Okay students, all right. So basically it means that if it would have been an SKM model, then the increase in output level would have been from Y1 to Y3, but in case of ISLM model, the increase is only from Y1 to Y2. So we can say that ISLM model or the SKM model overestimates the output level. So this is the difference between the ISLM model and the SKM model in case of rise in government expenditure. In case of SKM model, the interest rate would have been the same at this point, but the output level would have increased more than the increase in case of ISLM model. So this is our analysis of what happens when government increases the expenditure and how the IS curve shifts towards the right and what is the new equilibrium in the market. Now we will move on to effect of an increase in taxes. Well, our second fiscal policy change is effect of increase in taxes. Now the first question which I am raising here is that what will happen if tax increases? What will happen if government increases the amount of tax or the rate of tax? See, for consumers, tax is directly related to their disposable income. If tax increases, then consumption will fall. If consumption will fall, then savings will fall as well. Then if to remain at the same consumption level, the consumer needs to reduce their amount of savings. See, I can show this with a simple example. Suppose income is fixed, that is 100, and consumption, initially the family is consuming rupees 80. It means that they are saving rupees 20. Now suppose government imposes a tax of rupees 10. So from 100 rupees, 10 rupees is deducted, then it will become 90. So their income, so their disposable income, that is YD, is now 90. They cannot change their consumption. Their consumption will remain at 80. So now the amount of saving which they are entitling is only rupees 10, which means that there is a fall in saving by 10 rupees. So if savings will fall, it means that investment will fall. How? So let me show you here. We know that Y equal to C plus I plus G. This is the identity. Now I will show you that how when savings will fall, investment will fall. So there is a direct relation between saving and investment. See, Y equal to C plus I plus G. If we take C over here and add minus T in both the sides of this identity, so it will be Y minus C minus T equal to I plus G minus T. Now Y minus C minus T is nothing but the amount of private saving. equal to I plus, now G minus T can be written as negative of public saving, because public saving is the amount of tax collected minus the amount of expenditure entitled in the economy. So G minus T would be negative of public saving. So basically we are getting private saving plus public saving is equal to investment, which means that total saving in the economy should equal to the total investment in the economy. It means that there is a direct relation between saving and investment. There is an equality between savings and investment. So here we can see that if savings falls, then investment will definitely fall. Now in case of ISLM curve, we know that IS curve is the investment saving curve. So what result we are getting from here? We are getting that if tax is increased, then saving IS curve will fall, which means that IS curve will shift backward. So let me show a graph. Suppose initially the IS curve is here, IS1, and LM curve is here, LM1. The equilibrium point is at A, where output level is Y1 and interest rate prevailing in the market is R1. Now taxes are increased, so savings will fall. As a result, investment will fall. As a result, IS curve will shift backwards. IS curve will shift backwards. So there is a shift in the IS curve towards the left of the initial IS curve. So IS curve will become IS2 now. So the new equilibrium is at B, where output has fallen to Y2 and interest rate is also less this time. Interest rate falls to R2. Now let us analyze this graph. Okay, so the amount of change which is happening here is this much, that is delta T into the multiplier of tax, that is minus MPC by 1 minus MPC. Here B is equal to MPC. MPC is marginal propensity to consume. That is, if income of an individual rises by 1 rupees, then by how much amount his consumption should rise. Okay, now this graph can be shown using an investment schedule graph. So let me show this graph using an investment schedule graph so that it become more clear to you people. So let me show an investment schedule graph. Here on the y-axis we are measuring income, and on the x-axis we are measuring interest rate. Initially the investment curve is this. Investment curve is downward sloping because there is an inverse relation with rate of interest. If rate of interest falls, investment rises. If rate of interest increases, investment falls. So there is an inverse relation. So that is why the investment curve is always downward sloping, that is IS1. Okay, now investment falls due to fall in saving. Investment falls, and initially the interest rate was, suppose R1. Suppose at R1 the investment curve is showing an output level of Y1. Now investment falls. So what will happen with the fall in investment? If they have to remain at the same interest level, then output will fall. Or if they want to remain at the same output level, then rate of interest should have to fall. So there is a fall in rate of interest, or there should be a fall in investment or income. Okay, so that is why we can see that there is a fall in interest rate and there is a fall in total output as well. So this is the effect of a change in taxes. Now this part which I have shown here, this would have happened if there was SKM model prevailing in the economy, that is simple Keynesian model. So so in this case Y would have fallen to a much larger amount to Y3. That is, in SKM model the change in Y would have been more than the change in Y in case of ISLM model. It means that SKM model underestimates or you can say overestimate the total fall in output due to fall in taxes. Okay, so this was the complete analysis of change in the ISLM curve, only IS curve, when there is fall in the amount of consumption, that is due to fall in the amount, increase in the amount of taxes. Okay, now we are moving to our next fiscal policy change. So our third analysis is the effect of an autonomous fall in investment. So if there is an autonomous fall in investment, so what is autonomous investment? Autonomous investment is that part of investment which does not depend on the income, on the interest rate. Okay, so there is an autonomous part of investment as well which does not depend on the interest rate. So we will draw two graphs to explain this fiscal policy change. So let us draw the first graph. Suppose IS curve is here at IS1, and if there is a fall in the IS curve, suppose IS curve shifts from IS1 to IS2, and suppose the economy was at equilibrium at Y1 and R1. Now due to shift in the IS curve from IS1 to IS2, the output will fall to Y2, and this can be shown in ISLM curve. Due to fall in investment curve, this is investment curve. Due to fall in investment curve, IS curve shifts towards the left, and the new equilibrium is now at Y2 with the interest rate at R1. But in case of ISLM model, the equilibrium will not take place here. Rather, the equilibrium will take place here because the IS curve and LM curve are intersecting at this point, and R2 will fall as a result. Now, rate of interest falls, so there is an incentive for the investors to increase their investment, because now the rate of interest is less than the initial rate of interest, so the investors can get some more amount of profit by investing in the economy. So due to this fall in investment, the investment curve may go back towards the left, and if it want to achieve the same amount of investment that was initially prevailing in the economy, then they need to decrease the rate of interest up to this point, that is up to R2 point, so that they may remain at the same level of income. But this will not happen because there is a little bit of crowding effect, due to which the rate of interest will fall only up to say this point, that is R3 point, and this will happen because LM curve is not vertical. Now if the LM curve would have been completely a vertical straight line, then the output level would have remained same, so there would have been a possibility. So in case of SKM, we were talking that SKM overestimates the output level. So we were talking about the change in autonomous fall in investment. So if the LM curve would have been vertical, so if the LM curve would have been a vertical straight line, then the crowding out effect would have been gone, and the fall in income level would have come to the initial Y1 level with the new interest rate at R2. So this was the analysis of effect of an autonomous fall in investment. So this was all for today's video. If you have any doubt, then you can contact us at this number 9836793076, or you can WhatsApp us as well. And if you want to get more details about Saurabh sir's classes, then you can visit our website www.saurabhsirclass.com. For watching this video, thank you, students.